Okay, friends, YouTubers, and any Masport customers or Briggs and Stratton customers or anybody thinking about purchasing an item from Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers in Islington in the Newcastle region of Australia, I strongly recommend you watch this video. On the 22nd of the 12th, 2010, I purchased a Masport 4-in-1 home gardener, which is one of these units. Now, 2 months after I purchased the unit, I took it into Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers in Islington. Now, I took it in because the bar that holds the tines on, the nut and the bar, well, the bar was 9mm and the nut was for 10mm. So, in other words, it kept on coming off. And after 2 hours of use, I just got sick of it and took it in and said, look, they've got to fix it. And Masport sent me into Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers. Now, when I was in Newcastle Chainsaws, whilst it was in Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers and everything, I assumed everything was going to be okay. I got a phone call to come and pick the machine up. When I got in there, they told me it was going to cost me $60 or $70. And I said, excuse me, this machine's under warranty. Had to ring Masport, everything like that, and ended up having a big willy-nilly. And I also realised that when I got the machine home, put it on my front porch and actually saw it in the light, because I didn't really see it that much. I didn't really examine it, which I should have. And basically put it on the front veranda. And as I'm putting it on the front veranda with a bit of help, I noticed the dirt underneath the engine. Now, when I took it into Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers, this machine was extremely clean. I'd blown it off with a compressor, blowing any dirt that was on it on there, and there, trust me, there wasn't much dirt. Now, when I did get it back on the veranda, I noticed a few things besides that dirt underneath it, and I'll explain everything. To me, it looked like someone had actually used my machine, but besides that, see that oil build-up on the plate there? Now, that oil build-up on the plate, to me, is a bit strange, because like the machine had only done 2 hours, it wasn't there prior to the thing, and I was under the assumption someone had used it, because it was covered in a dirt that I didn't normally have, and because my dirt is black, like it looks black there, but please notice this is oil-soaked dirt on this side. Underneath, the underside is oil-soaked dirt. You'll see the colour of the dirt in a moment, which was a reddish colour in the now. And there is a reddish tinge. You can just sort of see the reddish tinge, but you've got to think that's covered in oil as well. Now, basically, when you hand, as they see the reddish soil that you can see there, it was on the top. And notice the rust. Please notice all the rust. Now, the rust is important because this machine was 2 months old, but in working life only 2 hours old when it was taken in there for this repair, and it was clean. I have a sand soil. This is like a loamy soil, like a reddish soil. It's got a reddish tinge to it, and it's normal soil, where I don't have normal soil. That's normal soil, but soaked in dirt. You can see just above the oil cap, you can see the reddish tinge to it, but underneath you can see like it's an oily machine. Now, my machine wasn't oily. My machine's, as I said, it had only done 2 hours' work. But during all these photos, please take notice of all the rust around the machine. Now, it is actually very important. There's one of these shots that I took that is actually of the machine. You'll see it in a few shots where it was brought home the second time. But please notice the rust up on that component there. And notice that the exhaust is peeling. Now, this is a machine that's 2 hours old, where that exhaust, which is that silvery fleckle chrome that's coming off the thing. Now, basically, one of the things that made me notice that something was different was the fuel tank. See, now, I'd actually inscribed my name onto the fuel tank, and I noticed the fuel tank was not connected up properly, but I also noticed this. When after all the thing, Masport wanted to know the serial number on the machine. When I went to get the serial number on the machine, there was no serial number on the bloody machine. It had been taken off. And if you look at that, that plate looks very old. Now, to me, yeah, that was a bit of a giveaway. But the next shot, now this was even after I got it back the second time, this next shot, Now, please notice the rust at the top left-hand corner and that little bit of dirt just between that nut. Now, notice the plate is actually clean this time. They've actually cleaned the plate up. But I took this photo because even after they did clean the machine up, you could still see all the rust. This is not a new machine, folks. I was not given back my machine. I was given back a second-hand machine. They tried to cover it up by scratching the serial number, which, as you can see there, as you can look at that plate. Now, the covering there, that doesn't look like covering of a two-month-old machine that had only done 2 hours' work. And why, you know, the scratches through the serial number? Why would I put... Now, also, the build date on this engine is 2008. Now, I was pretty sure my engine was a lot newer than that. And basically, it sort of... I'd taken these photos on that day that Masport wanted a thing. Now, there's the serial number plate again. As you can see, this is before they'd cleaned it up, and it was the yellowish colour. Now, notice all the rust around that exhaust. Notice that the peeling of that exhaust. Now, do you really think this is a two-hour-old machine? No, it's not, folks. It wasn't the thing. I kicked up a stink almost instantly the moment it got home, and virtually was told by Masport, as long as I've been given my thing, because I took it back to the Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers, and when the owner got back and the owner assured me that everything would be fixed and everything would be okay and I'd be getting back my machine. That's what I was told by the owner. Now, this is the coloured dirt that was on the machine. This was on the wheels. This was also one of the... It was like a red mud, like hard soil mud. And it was caked onto the wheel. And to me, that's not the soil I have in my yard. You'll see a shot of the soil that I have in my yard in a little bit. It sort of basically, yeah, it's not my soil. My soil was dark brown. I thought it was there, but when I come up to it, I'll let you know. I'll bring you back to the colour of the soil. If I have to put it at the end, I'll put it at the end. Now, there were other certain things that were giveaways about this machine. Now, about after I got it back, after taking it back under grudge, I should have taken it to court then and there, because that wasn't my machine. And basically, by what their warranty conditions were, unfortunately, you have to actually so-calledly accept these second-hand machines. I gave them a new machine, I get back a second-hand one. And yet somehow they got away with this, which is a joke. They shouldn't have got away with this. But Masport told me I had to take it. Could have, should have taken it to court. But so since then, since I brought it home, I've done the yard three times. Now, each time I've had to do it in hour lots, divide each section up into four, because of my back, I can only last about an hour each time. So effectively, it took 4 hours each time to do each section, because I can only do it slow. Even though it's not a large area, I had to do it slow. But the thing is, it sort of had to do it four over a period of 4 days to chomp it up, and those 4 days were over a period of a week, so it was only being used most probably an hour or a week each time. And please notice, this is the motor. After 17 hours, I took it into them because it started smoking, and now you can clearly see why it's smoking. There's something going on with the piston. Now, basically, to me, and that shot is a bit more evident in one of the box shots of it. So they said, oh no, they're not going to honour the warranty. Now, please notice the build-up of the dirt on the bottom side of that. And please, it's sort of, it's actually very, that dirt is actually very important. You'll see that at the end of the video, and I'm going to discuss that, because on the first edit of this, I've changed the edit of this video on the soundtrack because I found certain things that actually proved they've doctored evidence. And that this is one of the shots that's very important in regard to that doctoring of evidence. And I'll discuss that as we go along and in depth when we get at the end of the video. Now, the thing is, when you... Now, please notice that section again. Notice how it's very thin, extremely thin on that, on the right-hand side. There's not very much of a build-up on that right-hand side. And you can't almost see it, as if there's none just on that very corner near the piston. Now, again, this is very important in the thing. It's just something in regard to doctoring of evidence whilst it's in their hands. See, because when they disputed it, I went home and got a soil sample. Now, notice that there, it's fairly clean. There's no marks or anything in that section up near the valves. But the thing is, it sort of, it shows what the levels they've gone to. Because I gave them a soil sample on the day that they told me that when I took these shots, because they said it's contaminated. I said, look, mate, it's not contaminated. I'll even go home and get your soil sample so you can see that it's a different soil sample. Now, basically, I'm going to discuss that in greater detail, but those shots there are extremely important. There was a shot further on that I'm not going to discuss until the end of the video because I want them to really know that they're being stuck out. But after Massport asked me to go and take some photos of the engine numbers, and which I accidentally had, which I didn't realise, but when I went over to pick up the machine, get the photos of the machine, I wasn't there to pick it up, but when I got there, the mechanic had snuck around the back and walked around to the front with a box and all these components and left them out the front, and then that side of the gate is actually their very front door, front of the gate. The next, that other side of the grey is actually the footpath. Now, they said to me, the mechanic Neil said to me, your machine's outside, we don't want anything more to do with you, take your machine with you when you go. And I said, I'm not taking that, mate. I said, that's not the condition this machine was handed in, and ended up going down the street and went over to the United Servo and grabbed some paper and borrowed a pen off them and wrote up a protest sign and started protesting at the front on the footpath, legal, even rang the police and told them that I was actually doing a protest out the front of Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers. Now, I told them that I was doing it, and I made sure that they heard me protesting, and which I have a right to do, and I was on the footpath. I did not stop any customers. Two of their customers did actually walk over to me and ask me what was going on, but I was not interfering with their customers any way, shape, or form. When the police turned up, even the secretary verified to the police that I wasn't causing any problems, and I did protest, but the thing is, it's sort of that I treated her with respect at all times. After the police went, we went through the box. Oh, sorry, we had already gone through the box by the time the police had got there, actually, sorry, and sorted everything out. Now, in other words, they were keeping the machine over there and everything, but the condition that they actually tried to hand this back. Now, folks, that's a photo of Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers in Newcastle. These are the ones that tried to hand my machine back in pieces. And I mean in pieces. When I took photos of it originally, it was only the head was off it. That's how they tried to hand the machine back to me, in little pieces. They had physically stripped the engine into almost single components and bagged a fair few of those components. In other words, they wanted me to take responsibility for a machine in that condition. I would not have had a single comeback on my warranty if I had taken that machine. Now, if a company ever tries to do this to you, folks, do not accept the machine, walk straight out of the door and take a photo of it first and then walk out of the door. And I'm serious. If they take the machine outside, they are responsible for it still. Even if they put it on the footpath, they are legally responsible for your machine. You haven't signed for it, so don't ever accept the machine. If a company tries to hand you back a warranty machine in this condition, now this is the condition that Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers handed back my machine, tried to hand back my machine. And Massport, you are legally responsible for the actions of your repairers, by the way. And you still have to honour your damn warranty. And I mean, you have to honour your warranty. And the thing is, they've even doctored the evidence, because those photos that I said earlier in regard to the head, now you're going to see that, I think it's the next shot, I think it is, because I'm going to discuss it in great detail as to what can happen in regard to that. Now, please notice the condition of that. Now, please remember, I said I took in a soil sample, which was in that box, in that plastic bag in that box, which I'll show you again a little bit later. Now, please notice the condition of that head. Notice a big lump on the side. Notice there's it looks like it's been spread out like butter, as if they've gotten the soil that's in that bag and mixed it. Even look at the valve. Look at the thickness on that valve. Now, on the other pictures, it's up the other way. Now, this, see, they gave me three excuses. They said, one, contamination. right? Now, this is a photo I took on the day that I went in to have a look at the oil for, the warranty when they said the thing, because they said, oh, it got through. Now, notice all the build-up of the dirt underneath. Now, if that is the actual cause of this damage, that's actually a warranty condition because that component failed because it has allowed the dirt to get past it. Now, that means that component failed. But this component, now, I strongly recommend you copy this photo and enlarge it. And you'll see that it looks like they've actually pushed the dirt into it. And I mean, pushed the soil that I've given them because the soil sample was different. That's why I went and got the soil sample. Now, this is on the day that I went over to pick it up, right? Because that's the oil filter. It's got dirt pushed into it. And I mean, and you can see it. If you enlarge that photo, you can see the dirt's been pushed into it. Now, Briggs and Stratton should have honoured the warranty because I'll talk about how Briggs and Stratton do their warranties in a moment. But Masport, this is how the machine should have legally been returned to me. Now, that machine, when it was taken in to Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers, was in full working order. And I mean full working order. It was going, it was running, but it was blowing smoke. And it made a knocking noise. So I took it in because the noise was getting louder and I was getting worried. So I took it in because it's covered under warranty. And I was given back this piece of crap. Now let's go to Briggs and Stratton. Why I'm naming and shaming Briggs and Stratton. Okay, now Briggs and Stratton, how they work their warranties is they go on the recommendation of the repairer. Now, the repairer rings them up or emails them a photo and everything, and then turns around and says, oh, I think it's contamination. Now, you've got to look at it this way from the repairer's point of view. The repairer is going to make more money out of you paying for the job than it being repaired under warranty. Now, under warranty, they get X amount of dollars to fix a machine. How do I know this? I've got friends in the business. They make double the money that they would make if Briggs and Stratton paid them to repair the motor or replace the motor. Now, because they're going to charge you for parts, they're going to charge you for extra and everything, so they make more money out of it. And Briggs and Stratton go on whatever the repairer tell them. Now, this repairer is going to tell them anything because they swapped my bloody motor over 12 months ago. They gave me back a machine that was not mine. And like the more I, like the engine, when he said this motor's been flogged, I said, it can't be flogged, mate. It's only done 17 hours all up. And he said, well, mate, it's done a real hard 17 hours. But look at that rust on the machine. This is when it was given back to me after I took it in after 2 hours work. It's dirt that wasn't my dirt. And basically it was an absolute joke. And I had taken soil samples of them, but they have been lost over the last 12 months. And but the thing is, it's sort of the photographic evidence will still prove it in regard to the soil that's on the wheel, which is quite easily you can see it's a red mud and it's not my soil. And the thing is, it's sort of, but the way Briggs and Stratton do their warranty, that's an absolute joke. They didn't examine it. If a warranty's going to be knocked back, it should go back to Briggs and Stratton straight away. And Briggs and Stratton have a double check of the motor. Now, again, look at this rust. Now, this is where I'm saying that the motor was swapped. Now, even Briggs and Stratton said this motor was flogged. So, and again, how can a motor be rusted out like this, flogged to the shit house, and when it's done 17 hours hard labour, it's been well cared for, well looked after, well maintained. And I mean maintained. I change the oil more often than you're supposed to. And it was always had Briggs and Stratton engine oil in it. And not the cheap stuff. It was actually the good stuff. And I use Briggs and Stratton good oil in my components. My mower, I've got a Briggs and Stratton mower. It's been running for hundreds and hundreds of hours. And it blows a puff of smoke when you start it. But that's it. Most engines sometimes blow a puff of smoke because the oil's filtered down or whatever with these new slushes, whatever they got in them. Sometimes pops a bit of oil on top, but the thing is, it's sort of, it's been going for hundreds of hours. Now, I'm going to go back to this photo. I want you to notice how the clean label's been cleaned, and you can see it's been cleaned compared to when you see it in the other photos, but notice that rust. Okay, if that rust is on there after 2 months, my name's Jack Robertson, and my name certainly ain't Jack Robertson. And this is an absolute joke that something's been changed, and personally, I think the motor has been changed. is what I think. And that's what I truly think. I think the motor has been changed. And the thing is, it's sort of, look at the serial number. It's an attempt to cover over a serial number. And not very good, because you still could read it. You blow that up, you still can actually read the serial number. But look at the damage to the front of it. Notice the amount of bangs and knocks and stuff like that. That's off an older motor. Remember, the build date that's showing on this motor is 2008. I bought this in 2010. And I don't think they'd have a motor on a machine that's 2 years old and selling it out like that, because then it's not really a new machine, is it? It's a two-year-old machine, been sitting there rusting away. But they didn't. The motor I got was new. But everything on this, when it came back to me, just wasn't new. And yet Masport turned around and told me I had to take it. Well, rubbish, Masport, I don't. I've since found out that I don't. Now, look again. Look at that mud clay soil, folks. That's mud, right? That was the colour of the dirt that was all over the machine on the top and everything, but it was more a dust format on the top of the machine. That was basically the biggest chunk I could find. And again, I did take that as a sample, but I don't know where in the hell it is. And I'm looking everywhere. Trust me, folks, I'm stripping my house looking for that sample. But the thing is, it's sort of, Masport, you still have the legal responsibility to replace my machine. Now, Masport have turned around, and they've said, oh, okay, we'll give you the money back. Now, we'll go into that in a minute when we get up to that section. And I'm sorry this video is long, because I want people to know what's really going on in these places. Now, Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers should be bloody ashamed of themselves to allow their mechanics to try and hand back this machine in this bloody condition. And it's an absolute damn joke. This should not have happened the first time. And the fact of the matter is, it's sort of, they're covering up the fact that they've swapped the motor over by doctoring evidence, because, as I said, going into the next few images, you'll clearly see the photos that they so-calledly used to get the warranty knocked back have been doctored, and clearly doctored. They've fiddled with evidence, by the way, which is a crime. It's a criminal offence to doctor with evidence. Now, look at that component. Look at it. Can you see, like, massive lump there? No, you can't. Can you see a build-up on all over, a really thick build-up? No, it's a pretty even thing. Around the valve on the other one, you can see a little bit. I don't know whether that's actually a crack, and I think that's actually a crack, by the way. And I think that might be what they were trying to cover over in the other shot. Notice the thinness of it on this side of the component. Now, I mean, it's quite thin. You can actually see most of the metal on the valve. You can you see the speckling of the burning on this side of the component. It's can be seen. And basically, it's this side of the component that is the giveaway in the other photo, where you can clearly tell they've doctored the evidence. And I think, to me now, these are my best evidence. This is, I have actually redone this video to show you these shots. Now, these shots were taken on the day that I actually gave them the soil, because they showed me all this. They showed me the dirt that was on the airfield. I said, look, that's not my dirt. And basically, I went through what happened and everything, because the dirt was still basically reddish, because it hadn't done that much work. It should have been black, because my soil is black. So I said, I'm going home and I'm going to get a bloody soil sample for you. And I took a soil sample from out the front garden. I took a soil sample out the back garden. And I gave it to them. And basically, it sort of... And again, notice the evenness of the pattern. It looks like a stippling effect, like you would get on most motors that have done some work and done a long life. Now, this hadn't done a long life. It'd done 17 hours. In my hands, only 17 hours. So it's showing signs that it's an old motor, and it is trashed. Look at the cylinder. This cylinder is trashed. Now, again, you can see a little bit of build up on the bottom, on the other side of the cylinder, but it's sort of, but that's basically just shadowing effect to it. But you look at the other side, and it's fairly thin. It's a fairly even thickness all the way over. Now, this is very important. This even thickness is extremely important when we get up to the other thing. And I'm going to discuss it in greater detail at the very end. But Masport, when you're service representatives hand back a machine that was working when it went into them should not hand back a machine like this in this condition. This is an absolute damn joke. It's a joke, Massport. It's a bloody joke. This is the biggest joke of the lot. This is not how you hand back a machine to your customers. Your customers have a legal right to receive a machine in the condition that it was handed to them. Not in this condition. No way in this wide world do they have the legal right to hand a machine back in this condition. Right? And folks, if a company ever tries to hand back a machine in this condition, don't accept it. Leave it there, take a photo of it, and walk out of their shop. Right? Because if you take possession of this object, because it's no longer a piece of machinery, it's an object, or objects, because it's being stripped into components. Now, when you get back a machine on a warranty, you actually expect to get it back as you handed it in, not in pieces. And Massport, do something about your repairers. And it's not just with the repairer, Massport. This problem boils down to you. The problem lands on you at all times. And yes, no one should trust Newcastle chainsaws and mowers if they take in a warranty machine, because this is how you could get your damn machine back, folks. Newcastle chainsaws and mowers in Islington, in the Newcastle region, tried to hand back my machine in this condition, in pieces, when it was working, when it was going, and it was maybe not maybe making a little knock and blowing a little bit of smoke. And I mean, it was only blowing a little bit of smoke. It blew a lot of smoke at first. That's what scared me and why I changed the oil. But then it just went back to blowing a little bit of smoke. So I'd say when the rings actually went, it blew all the smoke. But then it settled down. And that's generally what happens when rings go. And when you rev the motor, which I didn't actually do, when you rev the motor up, yeah, you're going to blow a lot of smoke again. But the thing is, when it's now, something here. Now, in not just besides the way that all that dirt has been put on there, looks like it's been put on there with a bloody spatula. The thing is, look at the lumps and look at the thickness on the dirt on the valve. It's actually a lot thicker now. And you can see it's a lot thicker because they've taken the soil out of the soil sample and they've pressed it in and spread it out like butter and somehow mixed it with oil and everything like that. I don't know what they've done. And it wouldn't be hard to get used oil now. But going back to this air filter. Now, this air filter basically is supposed to be a sealed unit. Now, when you put an oil filter, an air filter onto a machine, there's supposed to be a seal, and that seal's supposed to work. But by the looks of this, it hasn't, because that shows that the components failed. That component, if they're going on contamination, fail. But again, this one, now this is in the box, after it's taken out of the box. It's got dirt in it, and the dirt looks like it's been rubbed into it, folks. And basically, I don't know why they did it or whatever, but it's an absolute joke. Now, going back to Massport. Now, I've told Massport I want a replacement machine. Now, a replacement machine, like if I wanted to go out and buy another Massport now, it's going to cost me over $1,000. $1,037, I think it is. It's even gone up $37 compared to the other day. The recommended retail a couple of days ago was only $9.99. It's now over $1,000. When I first purchased a machine, I purchased it for $729. So Massport, what Massport want to do is give me my money back and go and buy another machine. They've even told the, because Kim told me that Massport don't want me having another Massport. But they don't have the right to tell me that I can't have another Massport. My right is to get a replacement machine, and I could have a refund if I want it, but I don't want the refund. I want another Massport. Right, I want a Massport home gardener. It is a shaft-driven machine. It goes places that other machines can't go, and as a disabled person, it pulls me along. I don't have to do any work with that machine, and I can move that machine around with my disability and not have any problems. But, see, they're saying, oh, I should need a bigger machine. I don't need a bigger machine. I wouldn't be able to push a bigger machine. And my yard quite clearly only needs a small machine. And you can basically see that in that document that they want me to go and buy another opposition's machine. They don't want to, me to have the my legal right of getting another machine, where I have that legal right to get a replacement machine, mainly to the fact of what their repairer has done to the machine this time. That is an absolute joke. No one should have to accept that machine. Look at it, folks. Absolutely look at the damn thing. Look at the condition. Would you accept a machine back in that condition? Why would a person accept a machine back in that condition? A person would have to be off their mind to accept a machine back in that condition. So all I can say is to anybody, if any retailer ever does anything like this to you, then no, don't accept it. Do not accept it. You have the legal right to receive a machine back that you gave them. You have a legal right to get a working machine back no matter what, right? And basically, under warranty, when they do something like this, you have that legal right to throw it back onto the actual manufacturer, because too many companies turn around and say, oh, we don't have that responsibility anymore. Well, it always falls back onto them. Trust me, it falls back onto the manufacturer. They are the ones that employ these companies to do this. And if a company turns around and does something like this, you need to sue the company itself. Now, but going back to Briggs and Stratton, why I'm naming shaming Briggs and Stratton. Briggs and Stratton should honour their warranties. The way that they sort their warranties out with the retailer, because that retailer only wants to make money, and they make more money out of replacing the engine than they do, out of repairing the engine by you paying for it than then replacing it by Briggs and Stratton. They get a certain amount of money. So they don't want you to get anything repaired under warranty. Trust me, they tried to do it to me the first time. And the thing is, Massport, you want to be bloody ashamed of yourselves for allowing your repairers to pull stunts like this. Now, we were in communication and everything when we were going on. As you know, Dale, I was going across to take a photograph for you. I'd organised it with the secretary, and the machine, as far as I knew, the only thing that was wrong with it was the head bolts were loose and everything. And, yeah, but this is how a machine should be returned to you, folks, in the condition that it got to you. But Massport, this is what I expect in return. You delivering one of these to my front door. Do not give it to Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers to hand to me, because I don't trust them. I really think that they'd fiddle with this one too, just in spite. Well, Massport, you have to take responsibility. And it's your responsibility, Massport. Your repairer done this to me. Your repairer has no way of coming good with a new machine, right? And that's what I want. I don't want a bloody refund. I want a new machine, a new Massport home gardener. And guess what? I want my 22 months warranty from the time that I took my new machine into them and was swapped over, because I didn't get a new machine back. So I still want my bloody 22 months. And guess what? When we go to court, I'm asking for that 22 months back. Because that's what I should get, is 22 months warranty, because that was what would have been left on the, if I got my machine back, I would have had 22 months and I wouldn't have had a problem with it. Yet, I'll never trust Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers, folks, and I strongly recommend to anybody, do not trust Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers. Don't trust Massport. Don't trust Briggs and Stratton. They don't give a shit about the customers. They really don't give a shit about your customers. And the way I've been treated, and as you read his email, they don't want me to have another Massport because they know that there's problems with their retailers. They know I can't afford to go out and buy. If they give me cash back, I do not have the money to walk in and get another Massport. I don't have that money. Now, the Massport, as you can see, is a small unit. It has large blades on it. It's actually, the blades on this unit are as wide as some of the large machines. Now, it's shaft-driven. The others are belt-driven. In other words, the shaft is a lot stronger than a belt. So it's a much better machine. It goes places that others won't. If my motor hadn't been swapped, I wouldn't have been having these problems. But the whole motor wasn't just swapped. The whole bloody machine was swapped. I was given someone else's machine. Most probably one of the star, I don't know. It's sort of, you don't know. I can't say who did it. I don't know who did it. Now, I'm not defaming anybody because this all I'm doing in this video is telling the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, and I will swear in a court of law. And so, therefore, I'm not defaming any of these companies. I'm just telling you the truth. Don't trust these companies, folks. There's problems with them. Briggs and Stratton Motors, Masport, and Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers. Because if you go to Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers and have a problem, this is how you could get back a machine that is under warranty. They could hand this back to you. They don't care. They definitely don't care about their customers. And basically, if this had been repaired properly and everything, there wouldn't have been a problem. I must probably ought to take my chainsaw in there. My chainsaw needs work. It's going elsewhere now. Trust me, I wouldn't trust anybody that even worked at Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers, because if this is the condition that a company allows their mechanics to hand back a machine to their customer while it is under warranty, and it's an absolute joke. Now, the thing is, the best evidence is the next lot of pictures that you're going to see. And, yeah, well, they're going to show you a lot. Now, see, please see in there the bag of soil. That's the plastic bag at the top right-hand corner. That's the soil sample I gave them, right? I gave them to it because it didn't match the soil on the air filter. And, to me, the soil looked different on the thing. It didn't look like sand. So I went home and got a soil sample for them to prove that it was not my soil that was contaminating the internal of that motor. Now, when you look at this, now this is where it looks like it's been buttered on with a bread knife. When I first saw this photo, I just thought it was them taking a sample of the contamination. But it doesn't look like they've taken a sample. It looks like they've added to it. Now, look at the valve that's popped up. You can see that the contamination on that valve is a lot thicker. It's way thicker than it originally was. Look at the way the contamination is thicker all over the component. On the top section of it, you can see it's now thicker than the side bit where it is over the thing. Where on the other image that you'll see in a moment, you can see that it's one even layer all the way across. One clear even layer. Is that a clear even layer? They have actually doctored evidence. Now, I'll go to that shaft in a minute because that shaft's very important. That actually tells you the true problem of why the machine broke. But the thing is, it's a crime to actually fiddle with any evidence. Even like this, that's a crime. That's a criminal offence because they know this is going to go to court. So they have doctored with court evidence. So here I have physical proof they have doctored evidence. That's a criminal offence. They have actually committed a criminal offence. Notice how that is all even, all the way through. Even. Exactly even. Now, this was taken on the day that I gave them the soil sample because I said the consistency didn't match. Now, look at that. It looks like a bloody cake. It's been spread on with a bloody knife. They have physically doctored evidence. That's a criminal offence, Newcastle Chainsaws and Mowers. You want to tell your mechanics that? Because I'm going to see that they get charged, especially when it goes to court. Someone's going to go to court for doctoring with evidence, and I'm going to have it investigated by the police. And I believe that one they will have to investigate. Now, let's talk about the true cause of this. Now, I don't know if you saw that last photo, and I don't know if you noticed the stuff going down the shaft, but generally, when rings go, they make a mark and they leave a certain mark down the shaft. Now, it's actually the other image when we get back to it, but I'll go back to that. But please notice the even layer of contamination from the explosions, right, over that piston head. Right, and it's an even layer. Right, look at that, bread and butter. But look at the shaft. Look at inside where the piston goes. Notice how on the bottom of that, it goes down to a certain level and stops. But notice on the sides, where it goes all the way down, that means it's not the rings, it was the piston itself. The piston was too large for the cylinder and was rubbing. That is a manufacturer's fault. Briggs and Stratton, you have to honour your warranty. All right? Because that photo alone proves that I have full legal right to have my motor should have had my motor repaired straight away. You shouldn't just listen to your bloody repairers. And you should get engines back, because they companies like this doctor evidence. And I actually have the physical proof. And it's an absolute joke. And as I said, I gave this company a bag of soil on the day I took that last photo. There's the bag of soil in that Ziploc, double Ziploc bag there. There's actually two. You'll notice there's two Ziploc bags. You can see the bottom of the top of the Ziploc bag underneath the other one. And basically, I gave that to them to prove to them that the soil difference, there was a difference in the contamination, because one look, didn't look sandy. Sand has got a certain look to it. And they've swapped it over. Now, on the day that I picked it up, you look at the bot, you look at the, there, that's had dirt pushed into it. It's an absolute joke. Absolute bloody joke. It's a joke. Oh, I can't say anything more. And the thing is, Masport, I have a legal right to receive a replacement machine. I expect a Masport home gardener to be delivered to my home address upon arrangement of a delivery time. And I expect it to be in this condition. Masport, brand spanking new. You're going to replace this with a brand spanking new machine. Otherwise, we go to court. Then we go to court. I'll be suing you for 22 months warranty as well. And I expect to get in writing that I'm still going to get 22 months warranty. And if you want to cash settle this, it's the full recommended retail price that you advertise on your bloody website so I can go out and buy a new one.